In today's video, I am going to explain muscles that attach to cervical spine 1, C1, right? This is C1. C1 is also known as Atlas. It's from Greek mythology because Atlas, the Greek god, is supporting the heaven. It looks like this guy is supporting head. That makes sense. This part is so important for neck movement, head movement, and body balance. If muscles around C1 gets tight, that inhibit movement of neck, head, and maybe body balance might be aggravated. Thus, tension around C1 is so crucial. Let's get started. First muscle is this one. This is rectus capitis posterior minor. That's so long name, right? Rectus capitis posterior minor. This is tiny muscle. However, it's important for balance because around C1, there are many proprioceptions. Proprioception means kind of it's a balance sensor of joint. So, many balance sensor around C1. And this muscle is also including proprioception. Huh, if this guy gets tight, it's problem, right? Then, there are two more muscles attaching C1, like rectus capitis posterior minor. That's this one and this one. Upper part is oblique capitis superior. Or it's obliquus capitis superior. It doesn't matter, it can be oblique capitis superior or obliquus capitis superior. That's same thing. Inferior part is oblique capitis inferior. Oblique capitis inferior. These three muscles are called suboccipital or suboccipital muscles. These muscles include proprioceptions a lot. By the way, there's one more muscle in suboccipital, that's rectus capitis posterior major. Okay, but major doesn't attach to C1, that attaches to C2. So I'm not gonna talk about the major. Okay, I explained three muscles so far: rectus capitis posterior minor, oblique capitis superior, oblique capitis inferior. Let's keep it going. Next one is this one. This is thin, tiny muscle. This is interspinalis services. Interspinalis service. Very tiny, tiny muscle. Then, next one is this one. It's interesting. This is not technically a neck muscle, but it attaches to C1. This is levator scapula. Levator scapula. See? The name of muscle has scapula. So main function is this guy moves scapula. It's elevation of scapula. But it attaches to cervical spine. Of course, C1. So this is important thing. If levator scapula gets tight, that of course inhibits scapular movement and also inhibits for cervical movement because it literally attaches to C1. Very, very interesting. Next one is close to levator scapula. That's this one. It's so close to levator scapula. This one is levator scapula. It's superficial to levator scapula. This is splenius services. Splenius services. This is also important for neck tightness. By the way, if there's splenius services, there's splenius capitis. This guy doesn't attach to C1, but it's important to know. Splenius capitis is also important for neck pain, stiff neck, tight head, and headache. Splenius muscles, so important. I explained 6 muscles in this picture. 3 suboccipital muscles, interspinalis services, levator scapula, and splenius services. Let's go to profile view and let me explain lateral part of muscles and anterior part. This is profile view. This is splenius services. This is oblique capitis superior, oblique capitis inferior. I'm gonna explain even more tiny muscle. Let's go to this one. This is rectus capitis lateralis. Oh my gosh, there are so many rectus muscles around C1. This is rectus capitis lateralis because it's literally on lateral part. Then one more rectus muscle, that's here. This is rectus capitis anterior. It's so tiny muscle, but these tiny muscles are important for maintaining balance of joint. That makes sense. Then, next 2 muscles are gonna be so long name. Next one is this one, tiny muscle. This is intertransversali anterior services. Intertransversali anterior services. It's slightly anterior part of transverse processes. Then, if there's anterior, there should be posterior. That's this one. You slightly see that. This is the posterior one. Intertransversali, posterior services. There are kind of middle size of muscles and tiny size of muscles around C1. Actually, big muscles don't attach to C1, such as trapezius, such as sternocleid mastoid. Medium size and small size muscles attach around C1. And one more muscle. The last one is this one. This is on anterior part of cervical spine. This is longus coli. Longus coli. It's very rare muscle, doesn't it? Most of neck muscles are on back side and lateral side. Anterior part is so rare. Okay? I explained muscles around C1. It's good to know what kind of muscles are around bony structure. Then you can analyze biomechanics and movement functions. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button, comment, and subscribe. See you next video.